Levolution is the next step in player choice and how you affect the world and the world affects you back.
There we go, there we go.
There
you can
it
see it.
Is.
Look
oh,
at how beautiful
gracious.
That looks. Levolution at its finest in Battlefield 4, the explosions.
Hey there guys, my name is Shibby. Let's talk about the Levolution and Caspian border for Battlefield 4 when the map returns from Battlefield 3 in the Second Assault DLC coming soon. Right now we are in spectator mode, and as you will see about halfway through the match, the radio tower collapses, which causes a few interesting changes in this Caspian border map that were not in the Battlefield 3 version. This gameplay is from the Battlefield 4 showdown in London on the Xbox One, and I was grateful enough to play on Team USA, and we are playing Team Europe. Let's take a second to look at the Caspian border map overview from Battlefield 3. You'll notice that the US are on the right side, RU is on the left side. That has not changed in the Battlefield 4 version, but some of the flags have flipped around, and when the tower falls, it opens up a new route, which is shown on screen right now. More of the tower pieces are extended a little bit further out towards B flag. However, the part that you want to worry about, where you have that new entrance between the D flag and C flag, are basically what you see on screen right now. While you might not think, well, Shibs, this doesn't really, towers falling doesn't really mean much. Levolution, like, you think the whole level would change. But what you don't know is, with a map this size and the player count, we were playing 32 versus 32, it really does change a lot of the map, because you are so infantry focused on holding the D flag, which is this tower hill area, is so important for controlling the entire map. From there, you can pretty much wipe everyone out on C flag, which is kind of in the forest, and you can have a strong presence on B. Approximately 3 to 4 soldiers wide, an ATV could fit through, and you have minimal sight lines inside the broken tower. As in, once inside the broken tower, you'll either be focusing on the entrance or exit, not so much your left or right peripherals. In my mind, there are really two changes that do occur here. From, you now have that new tower type ramp, and also the wall here, it's really quite large, gets broken down into many pieces. This further breaks down the dividing wall between the B side, which is on the US, and the D and C side, which is more towards the RU side. And remember that the flags have changed a little bit from the Battlefield 3 version, so check the minimap, which was earlier in the video, if you're a little bit confused. One thing I do want to mention is I apologize about not having more footage inside the tower and whatnot, but we were not able to cap footage. We were there just kind of playing in the tournament, so there wasn't really much more I could do other than showing you what really happened on the stream. Here's another explosion type montage of what happens with the tower. It's only a couple seconds long, but this is in the Second Assault DLC trailer, which will be on the Battlefield 4 YouTube channel soon. And remember that if you do get hit by the tower, you will see some how you see impact damage as well. Anyways guys, this is my preview and breakdown of the Caspian border Levolution, which is definitely my favorite so far in Battlefield 4 because of the showdown and how much fun that was. My name is Shibby, thank you for watching, hopefully I'll see you guys next time.
Do you even lift, bro?
Do you even lift, bro?
If bro?